So we know our tide cost, and we know that our shoulder dictates where our feet are going to be. So if our shoulders are there, our feet has no business going apart from our shoulder, with the weight of our shoulder against the deeper distance. So when we start plow panels, if this is 12 o'clock for me, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, I start about 2 or 3 o'clock to position my hands. One hand, the top hand, is higher, and the bottom hand is lower, but they're in opposite directions in that the top hand, the palm is facing me, bottom hand is pushing away, the palms are up. At 1 or 2 o'clock, we start to move. At 12 o'clock, this is called cup or middle. You see what happened to the mid or bottom hand? It took a cup position. From this position, it told me that I'm 12 o'clock in the middle. Then I continue to move. At 10 o'clock and almost 9 o'clock, I flip and I meet. I move again. I'm getting in the middle. I have to cup. When I flip, I have to meet. In the middle, I have to remember to cup. When I close, I have to flip and meet. When I'm in the middle, I have to cup. My eyes are watching the tips of my higher hand, hand that is higher. Okay? This way. Everybody do it this way. So we know that 12 o'clock is here. Give me this 12 o'clock. But give me 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, then make your hands this way. Top hand is the left hand, it's higher. Right hand, the palms are facing away from you, slightly lower. Your waist is the thing that's dictating it. Your hips are not going this way. If your hips go this way, you're misaligned because your feet are straight ahead where your hips should be. So this is the position for parameter one. The torso and the waist make that 2 o'clock motion or direction. When you begin, you can begin with me. You start, you're at 12 o'clock as a cup. You keep on moving, 10 o'clock, 9 o'clock, flip and meet. Move to 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock is our middle, is our cup. 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, we flip and we meet. 12 o'clock is a cup. 9 o'clock, flip and meet. Cup at 12. Now, parameter 1. Open, middle. 2, flip, close, middle, 1, open, middle, 2, flip, knee, close, middle, 1, open, middle, 2, flip, close, middle, 1, open, cup middle, flip knee close, middle, look at the back hand, hook it, left hand closer to your face, step out away from the back foot, single leg. It's a linear side by side motion. My hips are always here. At no time did I go to my right or to my left. I need to make sure that my foot is pointed in the forward direction. In other words, this is how it should be. It should come up, down, parallel to the planted foot. Up, down, parallel to the planted foot. At no time can my foot go down. She said, put your toe down, and then you make this adjustment. That's not good. So we don't want to, we want feet that are parallel. Only move gradually and shift your weight gradually. Just the way you move gradually, you can move
want to just start something earlier. Having four movements, not just lift your leg up. You lift your belly from the leg up. That way you got better control, otherwise far, far. Shifting weight, lifting to this side, but you're pushing down on this side. You have to control it a little bit. Otherwise, then you get up, oh, no balance, you can fall. And that pervades form, this particular form, when you're going to do other things, you try to concentrate on using the central part of your body that makes
it. It's true with the limbs of your hands. It's not just this motion here, but it's dictated by the back muscle. Alright. So let's just practice now our feet, okay? So 50-50 touchy posture. Up on your left, off the ground, toe down, heel down, slowly raise the foot of your right, off the ground, toe down, start on your left, down, up, down, up, up, down. Okay, now we're here. This time, hands, hip. Parameter one. Open, middle or top. Two, flip knee close. Middle or top. One, open. Middle, two, flip knee close, middle come, one, open, middle come, two, flip knee close, middle, one, open, middle, two, close, flip knee, middle, open, middle, two, flip, close, knee, middle, look at the back hand, hook it, bring the left hand closer to your face, step out, position yourself, see, I'm apart and I'm 45, it'll never be the same rep line or same plane as long as I keep this span or distance. The left hand for a single rib takes the same alignment as your left leg, but it never goes over the tip of your toe. So right about the alignment of your toe is your left hand, palms away from you. Soft fingers rather than left fingers, soft fingers. Just like when you hold your ball. Your left foot is 45 degrees in reference point to the 90 degree left foot. If this is 3 o'clock, give me 4 o'clock, maybe 4:30, and then hook your hand, then bring your elbow in, then your elbow. This is single rib. Can you look at your feet and see if you're in good position and you have a span? Can you look at your hands to say they're not over my front left toes? And can you say that we have at least at 2 o'clock hook in the back? So it's not hooked like this, it's not hooked out like this, it's a soft bend.